made it, traveled from Palm Springs, had to come over here to Highland, California for some fishing. Actually met with a couple subs, and they told me there was basically zero fishing in Palm Springs. Right here we have Cubby from California Casting. So have you heard that the fishing in Palm Springs is kind of non-existent?
It's a little dry.
A little bit dry.
It's hot out there.
So where are we at right now, man?
This is East Highland. This is my hometown. I fished here since I was like 3 years old, and there's some toads in here.
Toads in here?
There's some toads.
So we're at a private catch and release pond. You said there's a lot of pressure though?
There are a lot of pressure. I mean, there's a lot of pressure. There's about 10 to 15 like local fishermen that fish here daily.
Okay. Well, we're gonna give it a shot, and him and I are actually gonna do a little bit of a challenge. We got our MTB boxes right here, and we are gonna see who can catch the biggest bass or biggest fish, because there's multi-species in
here. You never know what you're gonna get though.
You wanna do biggest fish out of here?
Let's just do biggest bass.
Biggest bass, okay. Biggest bass out of here. How you feeling about that?
I'm feeling pretty confident.
You're pretty confident? Oh, it's gonna be a good challenge. All right. Get going. All right, Cubby's ready fishing, guys. I need to do a quick unboxing right here. And let's get you guys nice and centered. There you go. Quick unboxing right here. Let's take a look to see what we got in this month's Pro Box. Bagley Minnow B4. Big Bite Baits Real Deal Shad. Net Baits Baby Mad Paca. Z-Man Crustia Z. Ooh. Rockin' Runner, the original Roadrunner. Z-Man Shrooms Micro Finesse Jig. And last but not least, a Live Target Coppers crankbait right here, crawfish pattern. This is the most number of baits I've ever gotten in MTB boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And looks like it totals up to, here the price is right there. So this box is actually, it cost me $25 and you get approximately, it totals up to about $45 worth of baits. Really cool lures right here. And if you guys want to get your own, I actually have a link down below you can check out and a promo code. You can use one route at checkout. If you're a new subscriber, $10 off your first order. But for now, we gotta get fishing because Cubby, you've been fishing for like 10 minutes. And I need to figure out what bait I want to throw first. Because there's a lot of pressure here, you know what I think I'm gonna do? I'm gonna try something with a smaller profile. Let's go with, we got another fisherman out here. Let's go with the Shroom's Head, and we're gonna try, let's try the Shroom's Head with the Crusty. We're gonna throw that out first. All right. Open this bad boy up right here. Nice compact head. Bluegill colors, which is the main forage in this pond, I believe. And the hook is semi-light wire, so I'm going to tone down the hook set a little bit. Pull out the trailer, little Z-Man Tough Crawl Z. What I love about these Z-Man plastics, you can literally catch 100 fish on them, and they won't rip. I'm rigged up. First cast in Highlands, California. You think the bass is spawning in here yet?
They're like mid-process.
Mid-process? Yeah, too bad the water's not clear. We could see them. We could probably see all the giants in here. Dude, this water's gotta be, that's gotta be, it's like mid-70s,
mid-70s.
That water's warm. All right, I'm switching up right here. Like Cubby just said, the bass are probably mid-process spawning. So I can't see them because the water's too dingy. You know what, I'm gonna throw out this minnow imitation and see if I can run it by one of them on a bed. Get a reaction strike, try this for a couple minutes. Got on the Bagley Minnow right here. Check out the action. Little minnow imitation. It's gotta be something here. Right by the, oh, there he is, got him. Oh, I knew it. I knew there'd be one there. Dude, it's a good one. Oh, it's a good fish right here. Right by that moss. Right by that moss. Good fish right here, guys. On that floating minnow. No, don't jump. Oh, gosh. When I felt how warm that water is, I knew they'd be up shallow. Oh, this is a good fish. This guy fights, California fish fight hard. I think he's hooked a little funky. He might not be as big as I thought. A solid fish, not a giant though. We'll take it, we'll take this. Take the start of the day. Come here, buddy. Hooked him good. Woo! All right, a little 2-pounder. Start the day off.
On the jerk bait.
On the jerk bait, dude.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I bet you wouldn't expect that bait to produce here, huh? That's why the MTV box comes in handy. You can try new baits that you don't expect to work.
You better get a weight on that.
Get a weight on it. Unhook her, weight, let her go. First California bass ever. I'm gonna estimate about 2 1/4. Get her unhooked on that floating jerk bait. This is actually the first time I've used a floating jerk bait in about, maybe 3 years. Actually, probably about 3 years since I've used a floating jerk bait.
Oh, wow.
Without the MTB, I wouldn't have even thought to throw it here, to be honest. But we're going to get a weight on this fish right here. We've got 2.27. What did I say again?
2 1/4.
I did say 2 1/4. Pretty close. My bass dar is still on. So we're going to go ahead and let this beautiful fish go right here. Get the release. Ah, awesome top water blow up. Got the hint from the pads that they might be hitting top water. Get nice and revived, should be good to go here. There she goes. Number one.
Nice, man.
Thanks, bro. Do I switch it up? Do I keep throwing that for a little bit? Well.
Damn, this box has got me so confused.
Does it?
I'm just like,
ugh. Yo, you have the experience of this pond, but I have the experience when it comes to MTB boxes.
There you go.
So that evens the playing field.
There you go.
You know what? I'm actually...
I swear, I like just get my MTBs and I'm like, oh, cool stuff.
Yeah, use it, man. You gotta experiment. That's what it's all about. Playing with different baits, seeing how each one's good or bad. And I'm actually gonna keep playing with this guy right here. Floating jerk bait, very light. It's a little bit difficult to cast in a bait caster, but it's really good wounded minnow action. So I feel like that's why that bass was enticed to strike. We're gonna see if we can get another one on it. That stuff is nasty. Here's the muck that bass is hiding under. And the bass actually don't really care too much about clean or dirty type stuff. They're just looking for some form of structure or cover to hang out in. That guy was right under looking for an easy meal. And how I'm fishing this floating jerkbait is similar to a suspending jerkbait, kind of a twitch pause type cadence, but the action is going to be completely different since this bait rises to the top. And where this bait shines is actually around the spawn, where you're going to be throwing in shallow water. You're going to want to throw this guy as opposed to a suspending jerkbait that'll get caught up in the weeds. When's the last time you fished out here?
God, dude, I don't even fish.
You don't even fish?
I produce music.
Gotcha, that's cool.
Yeah, bro, so I...
What kind of music do you produce?
I mean, mostly, honestly, hip-hop.
Oh, nice, dude.
I have my audio engineering degree as well.
Oh, do you?
So, like, I record bands and I record full sessions.
Oh, there's another one came up for
nice.
It. There, another little guy. It's gonna help me, but...
Hey!
Another one on the old minnow.
Nice.
Oh, I hooked him. Unlucky hook set right there.
Why?
A little eye piercing. He should be alright though. I hope. Sorry buddy, hope I didn't hurt you too much there. But these hooks are really sharp. Alright.
I love to fish, honestly.
Yeah, man.
I used to fish a lot when I was younger.
But you gotta fish more. Nothing better than it than
I know,
fishing.
Right?
And you live in California, the beautiful weather.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Oh, I let the little dude go. Cali bass number two. Feisty dude. All right, he's ready. Man, another fish on the floating jerk bait. A bait I literally have not pulled out of the box in 2 or more years. I honestly can't even remember last time I pulled it out. That's gotta be one of the best things about Mystery Tackle Box, just experimenting with different lures and learning more about ones that you might not have thrown before. Cause I only have one or two, I really only have one floating jerk bait in my box. And I remember, that's probably why I don't throw it too much, is because they're so light. And you actually probably should be throwing on spinning gear, but this particular model is heavy enough to probably throw on bait casting gear. Oh, he came up. Oh my gosh, there's one right here. Jeez, oh. Dang, on the pause, I was about to bring it out of the water. That's another 2-pounder. See if he comes back for it. Dang, man. Oh, he got it. That was so cool. Oh, jeez. Man, these fish are shallow, right? I can't believe it. Did you guys see that? He freaking came up. This might be a small upgrade. All right, let's land this fish. Oh, nice. Look at the belly on this fish. This guy has been feeding up very nicely. Look at this freaking belly. My gosh, this is freaking nuts. I don't know if it's the bait or if it's the pond, but all I know is that this floating jerkbait is absolutely slaying them right now. Three fish in the last 20 minutes. Been out here for about an hour. This guy has been feeding up real, real good. And I don't think Cubby has caught one yet, and he's fishing a drop shot. So I think it might actually be the bait that's producing these nice fish. But right after I complete the loop, I'm gonna experiment with different baits in the box to see what else is gonna be producing. It's just nuts. Floating jerkbait, guys. If you haven't thrown it this spring, definitely need to give it a shot. Whoa, my God, jeez. The freaking blobs are insane on this bait. Right in freaking front of me. Dude, monster fish. Please come back. That was absolutely nuts. What the actual heck? There he is. No! My gosh, missed another bite. I set the hook a little bit too early. He'll come back. He'll come back. Do you hear that?
Yeah.
Dude, that's what they do. Right on the paws. Right when it's sitting there, they'll pop it. Dude, sometimes it's those weird choices that produce fish. Cubby said that everyone here throws drop shots and they do really well in drop shots, but throwing something completely different, I guess that can sometimes be the most effective because these pressured bass might not have seen the floating jerkbait in quite a while. All right, it hurts me to do this, guys, but I gotta keep experimenting. Gotta cut this bad boy off. Jerkbait, put you right here. What are we gonna use next? I really wanna fish that fountain because it looked like that flowing water is gonna be, let's see, how big? 3/8 ounce or the crankbait crawfish, which is 3/8. Which one's gonna cast further? Because that fountain's kind of in the middle of the pond. You know what? I'm gonna try the crankbait first. Let's go and tie this on. The old coppers, really good color for a pond like this. Translucent, natural crawfish color. A pond like this that gets a lot of pressure from the same guys who all know what they're doing. Using a bait like this is gonna be different because they're all throwing drop shots basically. And it's also gonna still look pretty natural, so we'll see if it works out. There we go, that's the cast. Nope, no takers. I was thinking that maybe a couple of the bigger fish might be hanging around that deeper, fresh flowing oxygenated water. But so far it looks like all the fish have been shallow, coming from shallow water, right around the perimeter of the pond. But it's always good to experiment. You never know exactly, you never know what to expect, especially at a pond you've never fished before in a state that you've never been before either. Well, made about 20 casts, no bites on the crankbait at the fountain. Experiments with deeper water, but I think today is gonna be a shallow bite type of day. I'm going back to the Old Faithful floating jerkbait right here. And Cubby's actually...
I forfeited.
You know, he didn't forfeit. We're gonna do another new challenge. He's gonna throw his Old Faithful tried and true bait, which is a drop shot, right? Drop shot with the Robin Worm?
Yep.
With the Robin Worm. And we're gonna see which bait produces. The MTB floating jerkbait, which I'm sure these bass have never seen. These bass have probably seen a lot of baits. I don't think they've ever seen the floating jerkbait.
I'll show you guys, because this isn't anything special. It's the classic Morning Dawn.
Oh, dude,
actually,
Morning
not
Dawn.
The classic, it's Aaron's Morning Dawn.
Oh, nice. My buddy loves that color.
I like using Morning Dawn, just the original one, but I literally sold out every Walmart in the area. I swear.
Dang, dude. All right, well, I'm gonna use this bait. I'm actually throwing it on spinning gear now because this bait's so light, it's not really, just not suited for bait casting gear. And also be able to use lighter line to give the bait a little bit better action. Got a 7-pound fluorocarbon leader.
First cast. Mark.
First cast.
The Giants are coming.
Oh, this is the way to go. Spinning reel with this floating jerkbait. This is what you guys got to use if you ever use this bait. Light line. This feels so much better.
I gotta get you a surface iron, bro.
I don't even know what I would use it. I don't even know where to throw it.
I know you go to Florida.
Yeah, I do. Is that good there?
Cuda fishing, like out here, Cuda like, annihilate surface.
Oh, really? I heard Cuda's like those tube baits, those weird looking tubey things. You know what I'm saying?
Awesome.
Oh gosh, good dude, it came up. All right, this is the bait to go with. The floating jerk bait. We tried the finesse jig. We tried the drop shot. We tried the crankbait. The the only thing producing right now, floating jerkbait. Little pounder, well fed. They're loving this thing, man. I'll let you go.
Oh, he did a little wheelie.
Yeah, a little jump. Well, guys, that is it. I'm actually going back to the tennis tournament now. Girlfriend just bought tickets, but we got Cubby right here. Cubby, break down the day for us, man.
So here's the day so far. Mike killed it. What'd you get, five?
Yeah, about four or five, I think.
He got a 2.25, a nice one off the pads. Wait, was it off the pads?
Oh, no, it's actually
right on the bank.
Yeah, right on the bank, yeah, shallows.
He defeated me. I got completely skunked today. Wasn't my day, but he's gonna head out here in the next couple months and we're gonna get back on him.
Yeah, huge thanks to Cubby inviting me out to his secret little honey hole here. It's really, really fun time. And even though the fishing, this is probably the worst conditions we could have hoped for, because you've been slaying out here, haven't you?
It's just like right in that awkward time where the spawn's starting to slow down.
So yeah, it's tough conditions, but I will be back with Cubby. He invited me out to Catalina Island for some big yellow jack.
Yellowtail? Some bonita.
We'll be going out with Cubby and
Kyle.
Cubby and Kyle. That will be a lot of fun in the future. Definitely look forward to that, man.
You already know.
The jerkbait, man. The jerkbait literally, guys, was the only reason I would have gotten skunked too had it not been for the jerkbait. I tried a couple different baits, plastics, the jig, the crankbait. Nothing hit today. The only thing that could elicit a strike was this jerkbait right here. So there's something about the floating jerkbait this time of year. Bass fishermen know, I'm sure you guys know, around that spawn, pre-spawn type area, right when the water's getting warm, the floating jerkbait is just a killer bait. So that's really awesome that MTB included that, gave me a chance, reminded me that bait existed, because I haven't used it in so long. But I just wanted to real quick review some of the baits that I didn't get a chance to. I think I got a chance to check out almost everything except for these two. The net bait, creature bait. Basically, I think it's just a version of the bait of the brush hog, which is a super popular bait. You can see this actually it's more of a crawl imitation, and you can actually pull apart the legs, it looks like, for a little more action. This is also very good for right when the water gets really warm and the fish are moving up shallow, feeding up. And last but not least, we have this very, very interesting chatterbait style bait, but this is actually a roadrunner. And I'm gonna open up real quick, do a quick little check it out. Nice black and blue color. The hook is very sturdy, good sharpness on it. And it has a chatterbait blade, but it also has a roadrunner style blade. This bait's gonna have a ton of thump. I didn't throw it. It could have actually been a player in today, because the algae bloom at this pond is huge. Just a week ago, Cubby was telling me the water is a lot clearer. But this bait I'll be looking forward to using in the Northeast in some of my more stained waters. But that's it for the box. Thank you guys for watching, and look out for the next video. Hopefully I'll be catching some calicos.